It's a very busy day six of the filing of certificates of candidacy for national positions at the Sofitel tent in Pasay. The son of the late dictator Ferdinand Marcos, former Senator Bongbong Marcos, has filed his COC for president. The first tandem to declare their bids for president and vice president, Senator Panfilo Lacson and Senate President Tito Sotto, have also formalized their candidacies. Our correspondent Ina Raformina now joins us live from Pasay with details. Ina, go ahead.
Yes, Casey, both the Marcos and the Lacson and Sotto camps filed their respective certificates of candidacies for the national positions they are seeking just minutes apart. Former Senator Bongbong Marcos, Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr., arrived with his family here at the COMELEC Filing Center in Pasay City at around 11:13 this morning. And just minutes after, the camp of Senator Panfilo Lacson and Senate President Tito Sotto also arrived with their families. Now, after filing his certificate of candidacy, Marcos, who is running under a Partido Federal ng Pilipinas, addressed members of the media and answered questions from the media. When he was asked why he has no running mate, he said that the reason why up to now the vice presidential slate in their party is still open is because they were planning to adopt President Rodrigo Duterte, who of course earlier announced his candidacy for vice president, but just over the weekend withdrew his intent. And that is why Marcos is saying that his party is now undergoing consultations on what to do next and how to move from here, because well, for now they don't have any vice presidential candidate. He has no running mate. He was also asked if he was open to the possibility of running with Senator Bongo, who of course filed his vice presidential COC, and Marcos said why not, that is still open, but as of now no deal has been sealed. Also asked why a Sara Duterte and Bongbong Marcos tandem did not materialize, Marcos said, well, basically because she did not run, and that is the end of the story. Now, as for the camp of Senator Panfilo Lacson and Senate President Tito Sotto, who are running for president and vice president, they are running under different parties, Casey. Lacson is running under Partido para sa Demokratikong Reforma, and Sotto is running under NPC. Now, both are saying that should they win in next year's elections, they will institute a kind of governance that is disciplined, a bureaucracy that is disciplined, to make sure that the least of the people will be able to receive aid and will be able to receive basic services from government. Now, they are also saying that they want these elections to be clean and to be fair, of course. They want to fight a good, clean fight, and asked whether this is already the end of a possible one united front for the opposition now that they're filing their COCs one after the other. Sotto said basically yes, this is the end of it. And Sotto said that right at the outset he and Lacson were saying that they don't want to be identified with any particular fence. Those are his own words. He said that they want to side with the Filipino people. Now, just as a little backgrounder for those who are watching and listening to us right now, of course, Senator Panfilo Lacson is a graduate of PMA Batch 71, a three-term senator, also formerly chief PNP and chief of the Presidential Anti-Organized Crime Task Force. Now, as to his legislative track record, he sponsored or authored the Anti-Money Laundering Act, the Comprehensive Dangerous Drugs Act, the Anti-Red Tape Act, and Anti-Trafficking in Persons Act, to name a few. As for Senate President Tito Sotto, he was former Quezon City Vice Mayor. He founded the Vice Mayor's League of the Philippines and was elected as its first national president. He was also senator since 1992. As to the laws and bills that he passed, these include the Comprehensive Dangerous Drugs Act, the Kasambahay Law, the Expanded Senior Citizens Act, the Maritime Industry Act, the Train Law, and the Family Courts Act. Of course, he also was an entertainer and artist before joining public service. And lastly, as to Marcos Jr., he was a senator from 2010 to 2016, a congressman of Ilocos Norte, 2nd District, in 1992 up to 1995, and then again in 2007 and 2010. And he also served as governor of Ilocos Norte for two terms and vice governor for a single term. As to the laws he passed during his stint at the Senate, he authored the Philippine Archipelagic Baselines Law. And in 2016, he lost his vice presidential bid to Vice President Lenny Robredo by a mere 263,407 three votes. Now, aside from the Sotto-Lacson tandem and the Marcos camp filing their COCs this morning, Senator Migs Zubiri also filed his COC for his senator, and former Secretary Mark Villar of DPWH also filed his COC for senator. It's a long day, Casey. It's a busy day for us. That is the latest from the COMELEC Filing Center in Pasay City. Back to you.
Thanks a lot, Inara Fermina, there joining us this afternoon. Take care, Ina. Keep safe. Well, several groups are against Bongbong Marcos's presidential bid. The opposition coalition Isambayan calling on the youth to resist what it calls another attempt to erase the atrocities of martial law. Human rights group Karapatan described the announcement as shameless. For the group, the campaign against the return of the Marcoses to Malacañang, Marcos's candidacy is a great insult to human rights victims under his father's regime.
It is really unacceptable. I was then a student activist before martial law. So I was just practicing my basic democratic rights as a student activist. When martial law was declared, Amnesty International figures say that 70,000 people were imprisoned. I was among them. 34,000 people were tortured. I was among them. And there were 3,324 people or more extrajudicially killed.
A former commissioner from the Presidential Commission on Good Government believes Marcos's candidacy is just another way for the family to keep the money they stole from the Filipino people. The former senator's bid comes a week after the anti-graft court ordered the turnover of around 96 million pesos and $5.4 million in ill-gotten wealth.
Everything else that they claim to own, whether they admit it or not, is ill-gotten. Everything that they claim to own, whether it's paintings inside their houses, land in other countries, jewelry that was confiscated or still being hidden by them, everything, including whatever Marcos Jr. Uses to finance his lifestyle, to send his children abroad, to educate them abroad, to fund his campaign, for example, that's ill-gotten.
All eyes now on Vice President Lenny Robredo as she is set to make an important announcement regarding her election plans tomorrow. She's doing it a day before the deadline of the filing for COCs. Robredo was nominated by the opposition coalition Isambayan to be its standard bearer. Many groups also urging her to seek the presidency, calling her the true face of the true opposition.